you know, when you study a certain degree, it doesn't really hold you back from being capable to do other things. And that's the whole idea of saying you're capable. You know, we used to sell food.
We started off selling food.
Remember those days, selling food on campus.
We graduated, sorry to interrupt you. Yeah. We graduated as engineers. So we're engineers who are selling food on campus.
Yeah.
You know, we've just always been hustling.
Yeah.
And then but there's this one guy who actually stopped me and he was just shocked. I'm like, he was like, didn't you graduate, you know, because I guess he just couldn't process, you know, I mean, you just got your degree, then what are you doing here selling food and stuff? For me, I always say, you know what, guys, money is money.
Yeah.
If it means that I can sell tomatoes and get R1 million a day, I mean, what's a certificate? I'm not saying, I really do love engineering and stuff, but as well, you know, I want to gain that financial freedom, if I can put it. Hi guys, welcome to our podcast. You are capable. My name is Londega Ndebele. Sitting right next to me is my awesome husband, Bulelani Ndebele. Well, let me just let him introduce himself. Awesome husband.
Mr. Awesome Husband. You've already said my name. But yeah, so my name is Bulelani Ndebele. And as you've already heard, this is my lovely wife, Londega Ndebele. Maiden name, Pimba. Definitely. So welcome to the podcast, You Are Capable, and we're hoping for a great journey with you guys as well. So yeah, a little bit about how we met, babe. So how did we meet? Because I've got a different story about how we met, but you've got another story.
Well, apparently he met me before I met him. I don't remember.
Sure.
According to him, we met in 2012 and I only met him in 2013. Right. So how I met this guy, or my side of the story.
According to you.
I was walking, we're in the same campus, UKZN, and then apparently we're in the same class, but I hadn't seen him before.
Yeah.
So what happened was, on this random afternoon, I was just walking from campus, going to my commune, and then he stops me. And then when he stops me, he's like, hi, how are you? And I'm like, hi, you know, I'm just looking at this weirdo talking to me. And then he asks me if I am in the worship team. Okay, so we are also going to church together. So I'm like,
the good line, guys.
So I'm like, definitely, me and singing, like, we really don't go together.
Yeah.
So I'm like, I am definitely not in the worship team. And I also don't know what time practice is. And then he says, oh, okay, no, I thought you were in the worship team. And then he also said to me, oh, by the way, I'm actually in your class.
But hold up, babe, weren't you in the worship team though?
No, I can't sing to save my life. All right, so, and then he says that he's actually in my class. Well, I hadn't seen him before. I used to sit in the front row of the class, you know, all the smart kids where they sit. That was me. And then he sat at the back. So that was the first time I actually met him. And then I'd say the rest is history. And then he's got his own version of how he met me.
Yeah, so I've got my own version, obviously. Because obviously you know how it goes. You guys would know, as a guy, what happens is that you meet someone before you meet them, if you get what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you didn't even know I was looking at you, but I was already eyeing you, you know? So, obviously, in the Christian setup, it's all like, you know, the dating situation and all that. And obviously, stuff that we're going to be talking about, even on this podcast. But literally, for me, my story, short and long of it, is that I met you in 2012. Like, it was actually in the tutorial class.
God still needs to reveal that to me when we get to heaven.
Yeah.
I definitely don't remember meeting him then.
But that's where I met you, you know. And I met this amazing lady, intelligent lady, who was asking for a tutorial for me. And fast forward, I wouldn't say the rest is history. It's actually the rest is the future, you know, for me, literally, because it's like my love journey started there. And that was like, what, 7-8 years ago, you know?
You're the smarter one, so you do the math. Yeah, probably 7 years, 2013, you know, so...
Yeah.
It's been 7-8 years somewhere And then, so we've just been literally growing together from that time. I was 19 when I met him, and he was 20 at the time. Well, I was about to turn 20 and stuff. So we've just been the best of friends from then. We studied together, as I said, we're in the same class. So we would study together, did the same project in our final year. And then I think that's when we actually decided that, not necessarily decided, but we sort of thought, you know, we were each other's soulmates. Yes, in a sense, yeah. And then after that, we were in a long-distance relationship for like 2 years, 2.5 years before we got married. So we got married in 2018. So we've been married for 3 years now.
Yeah.
And then we just,
Amazing, by the way. Amazing.
It's been awesome. We've been honeymooning all the way, man.
But we should just, like we always say, so this is something we want to say as well. We must honeymoon all the way, guys. You know?
I mean, honeymoon every day, all day. Yeah. I mean, but we're actually just young people, very much passionate about God, about Christ. Sure. We love God very much. Mm. We are also hard workers. I think that forms as well the foundation of our relationship. As I said, that we studied together, we did a lot of work together from a very young age, I would say. So we just have had that work ethic and trying to build together from then up until today. So which has led us here onto our podcast, You Are Capable.
Yeah.
Right, maybe you can tell us a bit of how, you know, we got here.
Yeah.
Where all of this started and.
Yeah, so I'm quite excited. I mean, obviously, the idea is that we started as BNL, you know, BNL being Bulelani and Londega. And I think when we started off, it was more of a student accommodation thing. You know, we used to sell food.
We started off selling food.
Remember those days, selling food on campus.
We graduated, sorry to interrupt you. Yeah. We graduated as engineers. So we're engineers who are selling food on campus.
Yeah.
You know, we've just always been hustling.
Yeah.
And then, sorry, babe, I talk too much.
No, you don't. Like, you take the wheel.
And then, so I remember when we started off, you know, people would actually stop us. I remember there's this one guy who actually stopped me and he was just shocked. He was like, didn't you graduate, you know, because I guess he just couldn't process, you know, I mean, you just got your degree, then what are you doing here selling food and stuff?
Yeah.
So that's where we all started with our, say, hustling, if I can put it that way.
If I can come in there, I mean, that's the whole point to say. And this is part of what we're going to be discussing, even in the podcast, something to look out and look for and forward to, is that, you know, when you study a certain degree, it doesn't really hold you back from being capable to do other things. And that's the whole idea of saying you're capable, because right now with where we're at, as young as we are, we really quite involved in a lot of things. I mean, I'm quite involved in music as well. By the way, my album's dropping very soon. Watch out and look out for it. It's the title's God's Relentless Love, but we're not there. But, you know, a civil engineer, she's a civil engineer. She loves interior design as well. And the whole idea is that we love entrepreneurship. We love property as well. There's a lot of things that we love. And we just kind of feel like we need to share that. And that's part of the purpose, which leads us to the purpose of why we're doing what we're doing. It's to empower each other as young people. You know, one of the biggest things is to empower each other as young people to say that you're capable.
Exactly. I mean,
you don't have to. And I think, babe, you can actually even come in there. You don't really have to use only your degree to get a job. There's a whole lot of other things that I think we can get involved in. Yeah,
no, that's definitely true. For me, I always say, you know what, guys, money is money.
Yeah.
If it means that I can sell tomatoes and get a million rand a day, I mean, what's a certificate? I'm not saying. I really do love engineering and stuff, but as well, you know, I want to gain that financial freedom, if I can put it that way. So as I always say, money is money. So I think it's very important for us as young people to explore different opportunities, different sectors, and just be really out there and live our best lives, not necessarily, well, in all aspects or in all avenues, just live our best lives.
Yeah.
Of which that has led us to starting this podcast, You Are Capable.
Yeah.
Because it's more of us reminding ourselves and everyone else that, you know what, the sky is the limit.
Yeah.
That there's nothing that you can't achieve, you know, that there's nothing that's unattainable at the end of the day.
Sure.
So you definitely are capable of achieving those dreams. You definitely are capable of finishing that degree. You definitely are capable of starting that business. You definitely are capable of maintaining those healthy relationships.
Yeah.
You definitely are capable of being a woman, a career-driven woman, a family woman. You know, you're capable of it all at the end of the day. So for us, that's where You Are Capable actually comes from.
Yeah.
And it's also inspired by the book of Philippians 4 verse 13, where Paul talks about the fact that he can do all things through Christ who gives him strength.
Come on now.
So definitely there's nothing that we...
so you see why I'm married here. Like,
so definitely there's nothing, guys, that we cannot achieve. If you put your mind into it, I mean, you've got it.
Yeah.
I mean, so I call myself an advocate for living your best life holistically, spiritually, physically, mentally, you name it.
And you remember, even like for PNL lifestyle, there was the whole idea of saying, like, living the life.
Mm.
That was like the caption, even when we're talking to young people, interacting with young. By the way, guys, we're very young. We really are young.
We're young ourselves.
We're not going to tell you our ages for now, but we are really young.
Math, you know,
we are really young. And also, before I digress, let me honor this woman that I'm sitting next to. I mean, you heard her spewing a couple of words there of wisdom, and I love that about her as well. One of the things that I loved about her was the wisdom at such a young age when we met.
Mm-hmm.
And I really thank God for that, you know. And remember, when you find a wife, you find favor, but also, I kind of feel like besides the favor, the wisdom is also a very important thing. And so... coming back to You Capable, I mean, there's a lot of things that are lined up for this series and what we're going to be talking about. Yeah. And coming back to the Word of God as well, to say that as a man thinketh, so is he, you know.
Mm.
If you're thinking something,
it
starts here, you know. And we need to speak to us, especially even the young people, to say, you are capable, you know.
Mm.
Because I feel like...
you can do it all. You can do it all.
It's lacking in our society to speak to each other about saying that you are capable. Mm. Yes, I'm sure you've picked up from our conversations here that we are believers.
Mm.
And we do base our understanding in terms of our Christianity. That's where we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, for sure.
Yeah.
But for sure, whichever religion you're in, the whole point, what we're trying to put across to you is that you are capable as a young
definitely
person, you know?
No matter what your belief system is, no matter what, I don't know what may be, but you definitely are capable.
Yeah.
You definitely are capable of living your best life holistically, exploring as much as you can.
Sure.
And more especially, when it comes as well to financial freedom, you know.
Yeah.
For us, we've always said to ourselves, we're very young, so I think this is the best opportunity for us to gamble.
Yeah,
I mean, we just start to exactly make the mistakes now.
Yeah.
I mean, in our 20s and stuff.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't say we're in our 20s, but you know, make those mistakes now.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly. Whereas right now, you don't have any children that are, you know, attending school and stuff. I know some people do have children and stuff, but there are those that don't have, you know, even when you lose at whatever that you're trying to achieve, you know, you don't suffer that much. It's still just you.
Yeah.
For us, we also used to say, I mean, what's the worst that can happen, you know?
Yeah.
You can lose your car. You can always buy another car.
Sure.
Let's say you invest into something and it doesn't work out.
Sure.
You lose your vehicle. I mean, you can always bounce back.
Yeah.
So I think that as well is the advantage of being young.
Yeah.
Hence, I think we should definitely explore more opportunities for ourselves and try out more, pursue our talents, our purpose, and in our lives. So definitely, I think that is something that we are advocating for. Yeah.
So as we wrap up, which was the premiere of the season, basically letting you know what to look out for in what's ahead. We're excited. We're very excited to share our experiences with you, for you to actually also tap into the experiences that we've shared. And we all grow together, you know, and we teach each other as we go. We'll have guests on the podcast as well as we move on. We've got a very interesting lineup of people that will come through. But mostly, obviously, it will be us. Some from the business walk of life. Some, obviously, from the well-being, physical well-being, spiritual well-being, emotional well-being, you know, all these aspects. And another very interesting thing that we'll be getting really involved in is linking up young people with opportunities, you know.
Definitely.
To whom much is given, much is also required, you know.
Yeah, so definitely.
We've been very, quite blessed, I'd say, to really been moving through a couple of things in our lives with the help of other people. So we really want to extend that hand out to, because a lot of young people as well are, you know, demoralized with where we're at. People feel like I've learned, I've graduated, but then what happens? Or someone's just finished matric and it's like, but there's no career guidance as well, you know. We're picking up that a lot in our society, and we want to be that change. Hence, you are capable, you know, and this is where this comes from. So as we wrap up, I think that's really where we are at, and this is what we really want to communicate. I don't know if you have anything else to say there.
Yeah, so I do have just one final thing or a few things to add, that we are definitely looking at practical, you know, improvements of our lives. Different opportunities for young people from all walks of life. And, you know, as he said, that we've had people that have helped us as well in our lives. I always consider myself as a person who's gotten through life through God's favor.
Yeah.
So I always say, if I can do something that is so small that can actually result in someone else praising their God for whatever little that I've done for them, I would have achieved much. So definitely would like to extend or use this platform for different people to extend that favor onto other people and just get everything going. So thank you so much for joining us on our podcast. Please do not forget to subscribe. You can click over here, like and share our podcast. That will be very much appreciated.
Yeah, guys.
And all in all, as we close, please do remember that you are capable.